Welcome to the world of food. We are going to go on a trip around the world, seeing and learning about some interesting, unusual, and funny foods. Let's get going. Our first stop, Mexico. And here we have a traditional set, taco, burrito, and chalupa. But here is a different, unusual kind of food. Guinea pig. Large swamp-living guinea pigs called nutria are a popular food in Mexico, Central, and South America. Here we go. Where did we land? England, the United Kingdom, where one of our favorite foods is the Sunday roast. That looks delicious with a Yorkshire pudding, which is a kind of bread on top. A very common, very popular dish. Everyone knows fish and chips. Chips is what the British people call French fries. And here is an English breakfast fry-up. This one doesn't have any baked beans, but often they do have baked beans to go with your sausage, bacon, eggs, hash browns, tomatoes, mushrooms, etc. Black pudding is what British people call Sunday. It is blood pudding. Next stop, the land down under, Australia. You can tell the Australian flag from the New Zealand flag because the Australian flag has this extra star. There is a map of Australia. Mr. Campbell ate some of this meat at the World's Fair in Yasu a few years ago. Can you guess what this food is? It's kangaroo tail. That's an unusual food. But this is even more unusual. What is a witchetty grub? It's a giant worm. Let's leave Australia and travel to Canada. Everyone loves pancakes with maple syrup, and Canada produces most of the world's maple syrup. Poutine. Here is poutine. It is French fries with brown gravy and cheese and maybe meat on top. Tim Hortons restaurants that you find in Canada are similar to Dunkin' Donuts. They're famous for their breakfast food and coffee. From Canada to Spain. Tapas is a famous way that Spanish people eat dinner. you have several dishes, but with only small amounts of food per person. So these are different kinds of tapas. You can see there are olives and meats and sausages, bread, crackers. It looks delicious. This is seafood paella. We all know churros are very popular in Korea. And now we travel to the USA, the US, the United States. My goodness, that is a big hamburger for a hungry man. This is jambalaya, rice and seafood, tomatoes, green peppers, and onions. A great American comfort food, mac and cheese or macaroni and cheese. Beef stew. Chitlins. Chitlins are fried pig intestines that in Korea you would call dwaeji gopchang. This is soft and cold in the middle and crunchy and brown and hot on the outside. It's fried ice cream. Let's look at food from Nepal. This is their most famous food called dalbat. And in dalbat, you mix the rice with these other ingredients in the middle of the plate with your fingers, and you eat with your fingers. And this famous Nepali food is called the momo, which you can see is a dumpling or mandu. And the one on the left, they call buff, which means buffalo. And there is the buffalo they mean. They mean a yak. This is a kind of fried bread called sela roti. And here is some more beef stew, Nepali style, called thukpa. Very delicious. And finally, some different fried bread called chapati. Here is Mr. Campbell learning to make chapati in a hotel in Nepal. We don't have to go very far to get to our next stop, India. There is a map of India. You can see Nepal just north. And here is India's most famous food, of course, curry with naan bread. Here is a more unusual dish, red ant dip, made of red ants. We were on our way from India to Japan. Here is some Kobe Wagyu steak that Mr. Campbell ate in Kobe, Japan. Here is some delicious ramen with pork. What is unusual is that you buy your food from a machine outside the restaurant, get a ticket, and then go inside. This is kind of a Japanese pancake called okonomiyaki. And of course, the famous raw fish sashimi. And here is a special kind of sashimi called fugu, which is famous for being dangerous to eat. And here is Mr. Campbell eating some. And the final weird or unusual food of Japan is horse meat. And another short hop. Let's go to China. Let's begin our meal with some dim sum. These are small bites, a little bit like that Spanish food tapas, where you get many different small size plates of food. Here are some people eating fish in a fish stall. And this is bok choy and mushrooms that Mr. Campbell cooked in a cooking class in China. I bet you can guess what this is. Turtle soup. And here is another animal from the water. This is the famous Beijing duck. And our last dish in China is the bao, which is kind of a stuffed steamed dumpling.